Greetings, Frederick Hartnett Middle School, students, staff, families, and community. I am Jason DeFalco, Superintendent of Schools, and I am very excited to be here with you today, just sharing a very few brief words of congratulations to our newest inductees into our Junior National Honor Society. Now, this certainly isn't the manner in which we typically induct our new members, but I am so excited that we are able to move forward and do this because we know that challenging times call for creative solutions. And so we are gonna press forward and continue celebrating and honoring students at every step of the way because it is so well deserved. And so with that, to our students, I just want to tell you all how very proud of you I am for not only entering into the Junior National Honor Society and being willing to take on all of the roles and responsibilities with what comes with that title, but for also exemplifying the four pillars of our Junior National Honor Society, the pillars of character, leadership, service, and scholarship. And each one of you possess the attributes and the qualities that really exemplify these four areas. And these areas are more than just pillars of our Junior National Honor Society and National Honor Society students when you get to the high school. But these are values that we have to lean into on a daily basis as we continue to prepare ourselves to serve and lead others. And students, I hope you are prepared to do just that because one leadership lesson you will learn very early on in your journey is that to lead is to serve. And you've seen examples of leadership, I'm sure, even in your short time, where strong leaders really embrace that mindset of service leadership and help to work and make their communities a better place, to make their environments, their teams, wherever you are, a better place through that idea of serving others and helping to support the needs of others. And I am confident that you are all going to do just that. I wish we could be together to celebrate, but regardless, I just want to say how proud I am of all of you. I want to thank all of the school administration and teachers and families for helping to really push you forward and send you my warmest wishes and best of luck as you proceed forward, taking head on the responsibilities of being a Junior National Honor Society member. Congratulations, and I hope to see you soon. Thanks so much.
Hi, National Junior Honor Society students. I'm very excited that we're still able to have, even though it's virtual, our ceremony for today. I can't thank you enough for all of the volunteer hours that you've done and everything that you've done to help improve our school community this year. We greatly appreciate it. For those of you just joining, you've got some big shoes to fill, but I know that you can do it, and we look forward to all that you have to accomplish next year. And congratulations on your hard work to earn this achievement. Have a great day.
Superintendent Dave Falco, Principal Mrs. Kurt Horn, members of the faculty, parents, and students, welcome to the 2020 National Junior Honor Society induction ceremony. We are gathered here to formally recognize those students who have been selected by our school for successfully completing the candidacy and are being inducted as new members of our NJHS chapter. For current members and those former members who may be among our guests, we hope this will serve to remind you of the standards of excellence you are too charged with maintaining as members of the nation's oldest, largest, and most prestigious student recognition program. Our chapter is proud to have been inducting new members since 1990, and with today's ceremony indicates the continuing emphasis on excellence that we represent for our schools and community. Throughout the years, members of our chapter serve as role models for other students. In addition to the strong academic records, which establish the eligibility for memberships, our chapter members are leaders in the many student organizations, and we serve our school and community through many activities, including Halloween candy buyback, winter clothing drive for Neighbors Helping Neighbors, and the Pennies for Patients fundraiser for the Leukemia / Lymphoma Society. We are proud of this record of accomplishments and welcome these new members who bring new energy and support of continuing our work as NJHS members. It is at this time that we proclaim to all in attendance that membership in the Frederick W. Hartnett Chapter of the National Junior Honor Society has been earned by these candidates through the effective demonstration of the four qualities that serve as standards for the society. The current offices of the chapters will now review these qualities for the candidates. We begin with scholarship, read by Chapter Vice President Parker Gilbert.
Scholarship denotes a commitment to learning. A student is willing to spend hours in reading and study, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. Knowledge is one great element in life which leads to the highest success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning furnishes the lamp by which we read the past, the torch guiding us to understand the present, and the light that illuminates the future. Candidates have the charge to continually expand their world through the opportunities inherent in scholarship. The second quality is service, read by Chapter Service Hour Coordinator Kendra Richardson.
My office is service. Service can be established in the routine of the day's work where many opportunities arise to help others both at school and in the community. A willingness to work for the benefit of those in need without monetary compensation or public recognition is the quality we seek in our membership and promote for the entire student body. We are committed to volunteering our time and talents to the creation of a better tomorrow. The third quality is leadership, read by Chapter President Hannah Finch.
Leadership should exert a wholesome influence on the school. The price of leadership is sacrifice, the willingness to yield one's personal interests for the interests of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. No matter what power and resources may exist in a school, community, or nation, they are ineffectual without the guidance of a wise leader. Leadership is always needed. Thus, to lead is a meaningful and substantive charge to each of our members. The fourth quality is character, read by Chapter Secretary Savannah Sharon.
Character is the force within the individual that distinguishes each person from others. It is this force of character that guides one through life and, once developed, grows steadily within. Character is achieved and not received. It is the product of constant thought and action, the daily striving to make the right choice. We must be, in reality, what we hope to appear to others. By demonstrating such qualities as respect, responsibility, trustworthiness, fairness, caring, and citizenship, we hope to prove by example that we value character. The final quality is citizenship, read by True Coordinator Chamberlain Boulay.
I represent citizenship, the obligations each member of our society faces to live up to the democratic ideals given to us by the founders of our country. The responsibilities each of us has to our home community, our state, our nation, and our worlds are many. Good citizens work together to improve not only their lives, but the lives of our fellow citizens. Good citizenship requires that we remain strong and vigilant in protecting the freedoms and rights that have been granted to us in preventing injustice from entering lives. We, the members of the chapter, are called to live up to the high standards of citizenship from this day forward.
At this time, will the new inductees please rise, raise your right hand, and repeat the pledge after me. Please join me in reciting the pledge. I pledge to uphold the high purposes of the National Junior Honor Society, to which I have been selected. I will be true to the principles for which it stands. I will be loyal to my school and will maintain and encourage the high standards of scholarship, leadership, service, citizenship, and character. Please be seated. We would like to introduce and welcome the newly inducted members of the 2020 National Junior Honor Society. We wish you the best of luck in the coming year and hope that you continue to uphold the values of the Frederick W. Hartnett Chapter of the National Junior Honor Society.
Congratulations to all of the newly inducted members of the National Junior Honor Society. Before concluding the ceremony, I would like to announce the names of the recently elected officers by the new inductees. I know they will work hard to expand and achieve the goals of the National Junior Honor Society. Your organization will have a successful year under the leadership of the following officers. Tutor Coordinator, Addison Baldini. Service Hour Coordinator, Creighton Murdoch. Secretary, Catherine Tasker. Vice President, Kaylee Thrill. And President, Nathaniel Cook. Congratulations. This concludes the National Junior Honor Society virtual induction ceremony. As you move into the summer months and beyond, I hope you will continue to uphold the values of the National Junior Honor Society: scholarship, service, leadership, character, and citizenship. Thank you.